Hey all, welcome to ShareTrek. Today we are going to talk about the first HIV therapy in the pipeline of ViiV Healthcare. And it's a broadly neutralizing antibody, or as we call it, bNAb. The name for this antibody or the code is N6LS. It's referred to in their pipeline as VH3810109. So let's get started. Welcome back, friends. Broadly neutralizing antibodies, or bNAbs, are antibodies that can recognize and block the entry of different strains of HIV virus into healthy cells. N6LS is a bNAb that works by binding to a specific site, which is the GP120 on the surface of HIV, that prevents its entry into immune system cells, which is CD4 plus T cells. By blocking HIV's entry into human CD4 plus cells, the virus is unable to replicate, and the HIV transmission process may be prevented. As per a report from that 2022, the Phase 2A Banner study, which was a randomized, open-label, two-part, multicenter study to evaluate safety, pharmacokinetics, and antiviral activity of N6LS among around 14 treatment-naive adults living with HIV, N6LS was evaluated as a monotherapy, with each of the participants receiving a single intravenous infusion of either 40 mg per kilo dose or approximately 4 mg per kilo dose, followed by 48 weeks of standard of care antiretroviral therapy. At the conclusion of the monotherapy period, the virologic response to the bNAbs was seen in 13 of the 14 participants, with a median viral count reduction from baseline of 1.72 and 1.18 log base 10 copies per ml for the 40 mg per kilogram and approximately 4 mg per kilogram treatment arms, respectively. When administered at 40 mg by kg, N6LS led to a robust decline in viral load consistent with antiviral activity reported for other bNAbs. The viral load decline and duration of response observed in the 10-fold lower dose or 4 mg per kg exceeded efficiency reported by other bNAbs at similarly low doses. Let me explain all of this in simplified terms. Clinical testing a new type of HIV treatment called bNAb, or broadly neutralized antibody, the study had two arms. One with a high dose, that is 40 mg per kilogram, and a lower dose, which is 4 mg approximately per kilogram of bNAb. Key findings was the virological response, which showed after the initial treatment period with the monotherapy, a successful viral response, which is the reduction in the amount of virus, was observed in 13 out of 14 participants, which is a very high level across both the groups. Viral load reduction, that is the amount of virus in the blood, decreased significantly compared to baseline, that is before the treatment was started. The high dose group had a median reduction of 1.72 log base 10 copies per ml, while low dose group saw a reduction of 1.18 log base 10 copies per ml. Log base 10 means the virus level dropped 100 times to 1000 times. High dose efficiency was confirmed. The high dose, that is 40 milligrams per kilo, confirmed the expected antiviral activity of broadly neutralized antibodies. And surprisingly, the low dose, that is 4 mg per kilogram, resulted in a significant viral load decline and sustained response. This effect was even better than what has been seen with other bNAbs at such low doses. Then we come to the conclusion regarding treatment with a single IV infusion of N6LS, which was well tolerated with few drug-related adverse events and no adverse events leading to discontinuation. However, adverse events were reported by 9 participants, that is almost 56%, with all adverse events being mild to moderate in nature. 6 of the AEs were considered drug-related, so AE stands for adverse events. And these included reports of abdominal pain from 2 participants and gastrointestinal pain, pruritus, asthenia, and myalgia. Pruritus means itching, which can occur anywhere on the body, not just a specific area. Asthenia means that it signifies weakness or lack of energy, which is a general symptom and not related to a specific body area. Myalgia means muscle pain and can affect various muscle groups throughout the body. On March 6, 2024, ViiV Healthcare will present update data on a whole bunch of their pipeline items at the CROI 2024 conference. This will include phase 2A findings from the banner study of VH3810109 or N6LS, which is what we are talking about in this video today. And once it is presented, researchers will share findings of the bNAbs administered intravenously, and the first efficacy findings of its subcutaneous administration will be presented. Findings from the SPAN study, that is SPAN study of N6LS, examining the safety and tolerability of the highest subcutaneous and intravenous N6LS doses administered to date, will also be presented with and without PH20. And the therapy is currently in the phase 2 study, and then they will have one more study in the clinical trial before it gets monetized and released to the market. So we in this channel will be keeping track of this therapy going forward. So please subscribe and press the notify button to make sure you do not miss these video updates. So whenever a new video is uploaded in the channel, you'll get to know about it. Better still, join our Patreon and get early release videos of these videos and support the channel so that we can keep up doing this good work of bringing you latest updates. That's all for now, and we'll be back soon with the next video. Bye for now.